So hello everybody. After a long time we are meeting again. So the course that I'll be taking for this semester is Technological Innovation Management and Entrepreneurship, 18 ES 51. This is a course that has been renamed, previously called as Management and Entrepreneurship. I am Ashwini VR, PC department. So I'd like to walk you through the context, the course outcomes that are expected of you after you go through this, the necessary textbooks and the materials, and of course the 5 modules that will be ensuring. Apart from having the company's vision, manifesto, etc., it makes sense to be able to chart a strategy for growth and for future scope or the future of the institute or the company. Management charts the best practices to do this. Also, the idea of making management studies mandatory is that there is a very fine line between efficiency and effectiveness. A person may be very efficient in reading and he might be very good at doing the job, but the effectiveness of the job may not be all that great. So how does one go about being most efficient as well as effective is what management targets. In modern times, it is seen that the most important aspect is perhaps communication. So why so? Many a times it is not only to be able to effectively communicate with others, but almost all our jobs are about getting things done through people. I would even go as far as saying that the things that are learned in practice are probably the only things that are worth learning. The first one in this aspect is communication. It not only helps others to know what you intend to do or what you want to do or speak, but also it helps in many things like getting a job, getting your credentials known for the work that you have actually done, as well as it is very essential to be able to know why and how much of the things are complete and measure against how it should be. So these metrics are best studied through management. So I rest my case with this particular slide telling that it's also about how one contributes to the society, and more importantly, the key takeaway for this particular course or a redesigned course has been about starting your own venture, probably your own company. So the whole idea is for you to be able to grow money by your thoughts. So to be able to drive this, one needs to be able to manage their time, economy, words and thoughts very well. So this is the scope of this particular. So our university, Vishveshwara Technical University, has drafted 4 outcomes such that the student should be able to start a business on their own, making use of all the concepts that they will study in this course. Basically, management as well as entrepreneurship. The student should also be able to take up social responsibilities and be aware of it and function as good managers and entrepreneurs. To be able to start a new venture or something on their own, the student should be able to draft a business plan and understand what components lie in doing this. Lastly, the major outcome should be for the student to be able to appreciate by being aware of sources where he can solicit funds for starting his venture. It can be institutions or individual sources. So the idea of management is available in very popular textbooks, but the one prescribed is by Dr. P.C. Tripathi and P.N. Reddy, Principles of Management, McGraw-Hill Publications. And for entrepreneurship, the primary textbook would be by Madam Purnima Charanthiman, where small businesses and entrepreneurship development has been discussed in detail. So we will be primarily referring to these two textbooks extensively. Apart from this, the textbook by Professor Vasant Desai on Dynamics of Entrepreneurial Development and Management has also been used for modules 4 and 5. Textbook 4 is available by the authors Robert Risch, Matthew Manimala, and Michael Peters. Apart from this, a very well-known book which I have been referring to over the years is by Koons and Weyrich, Essentials of Management. Okay, so I have listed out the textbooks used, but having gone through a lot of materials available on the net as well as these textbooks, I have come to the firm opinion that management, unlike most subjects that people appreciate as a theory, can only be practiced and learnt better. So though these textbooks give you information that you can gather and process, it would be best appreciated by doing rather than reading and listening. So I have drafted some exercises which will be done on a day-to-day basis. So these assignments will be shared to you shortly. But having told that assignments would be the only means for you to appreciate it, let's just go through what you will be actually expecting in the course. So module 1 has basically two components, management and planning. So you would be actually gaining some deep insight into what constitutes management, what do managers do, why is it that management has been put at the center focus, the different roles of a manager, levels in management, top, middle and bottom, the skills one needs to be a good manager, to incorporate them, the subtle difference between management and administration, and is management a science, art or profession. So why is this important is because the practice of management principles needs to be done very thoroughly as well as understood well. So we would be referring to the textbook 1 by Professor Tripathi for this. Planning is the second half of this module, wherein the nature, importance, types and the limitations in planning would be discussed in detail. I feel perhaps in the whole course, planning and organization that we'll be studying in the next module are probably the two most important takeaways in this particular course. Why so? You will be able to see this through the different assignments that I have in plan for you. But most importantly, planning enables one to make decisions. So this is at the first module. Again, we would be referring to the textbook by Professor Tripathi for this. So I had briefed you that in module 1, you would be basically going through what management is and how does one plan. But the idea of planning is to be able to organize things better and do things in a more efficient way. So this being said, why, what, and how of organization, the process and the principles, and departmentalization or committee forming, and the basic merits, demerits of decentralization, and how would one authorize this, and how would one be responsible for things. This would be what would be discussed in module 2. The second half of module 2 will be basically about being able to direct people and to be able to control the activities. So directing involves communication, which is again a major facet that one certainly needs to study in detail. So it is not about being able to communicate in a definite language, but being able to communicate what needs to be done, as I said earlier on. So this requires that a person be able to lead a team, say, in a definite direction, and be able to coordinate the activities of a team such that they be able to successfully reach the milestones. So why is this important is because only when you reach definite milestones, you'll be able to control the various activities and probably take definitive measures to see to the fruition of the task. Again, for this particular module, we would be referring to Professor Tripathi's textbook. Okay, so module 3 is a definite edition with a different take on management, which is very important that one appreciates that as an engineer, as a citizen, one has definite responsibilities towards the society. And what it actually means to be able to do this in the right manner. How business entities and different groups should be socially responsible and aware, conduct social audits, and be able to ethically manage their corporate bodies is what is going to be discussed. And this again would be covered by Professor Tripathi's textbook. The second half of module 3 would be regarding entrepreneurship, what it is, how, and types of entrepreneurs, and basically it would be setting the context to the development of an entrepreneur, the stages he or she has to go through, and of course the problems that they face, and what can be done to negate or rather overcome these problems. So this would be from the textbook by Dr. Purnima Charantimath, and basically we would be referring to chapter 2. The interesting part on in module 4 is about family run business. So now this is something pretty unique, and of course we would be actually looking at only the India perspective, how different family businesses in India have prospered and how they have actually contributed to the growth of the country. The stages and development in such family businesses, the incubation time, typical, and these things are discussed in detail in this particular portion of the module. We'll be referring to Professor Purnima's textbook. The next half is on idea generation and feasibility. So what are the roles that creativity and innovation plays in identifying business opportunities, and so on and so forth would be discussed in idea generation. So module 4 is about market strategies that one needs to keep in mind while generating ideas. The feasibility, if it has to succeed in a market, what are the requirements that the financial feasibility constraints imposes, how should it be economically, politically, as well as socially and legally feasible, and of course the technical feasibility, and how one needs to manage it as far as the manager's perspective is concerned, and other aspects about how one starts an enterprise on his own. So we'd be referring to Professor Purnima Charantimath's textbook. So in module 5, we would be having the detail of developing a business model. How would one analyze a business model? How would one draft a business plan to go about it? The necessary financials, the marketing plans, the HR service plans, and how to actually draft a plan in such a way that it goes from success to success. Basically, this again would be from chapter 8 of Dr. Purnima's textbook. The second half of this particular module would be on the financing part. And this is a very interesting part because this gives the tenets as to how to start a business and where different financial opportunities and identify it basically. The banking sources or different instruments that one can approach for funding, and the non-banking institutions as the venture capitals, etc. would be discussed in detail. The interesting part of module 5 is that it also covers the pre-launch, the post-launch requirements, the procedure for getting the licenses, etc., and the challenges and difficulties faced in starting an enterprise. Again, we would be heavily referring into chapters 5, 7, and 8 of Dr. Purnima Charantimath. The next half of this particular module would be on project design and network analysis. Basically, we would be just studying three network analysis techniques. Project evaluation and review technique known as PERT and critical path method CPM, as well as network identification and their limitations and differences. We would be referring to the textbook by Professor Vasant Desai for this. So with this, I guess I have given a comprehensive introduction to the different modules that are going to be covered.